You look at the way that they used to make swords in Japan for thousands of years, mixing material properties. I think additive manufacturing is going to enable a lot of that on aerospace.
The polymeric side has gone from the traditional low-melt materials, non-reinforced materials, to now what you're going to see is an integration of engineered materials, as well as you start to talk about things like higher melt point and higher use temp type products.
Being flame retardant, being stiffer, more elastic, tougher, appearance requirements, and it all starts down with material selections.
Obviously it's very regulated and there's a lot of very detailed customer requirements. So here at Jabil Additive, we're machine agnostic and we select platforms that gives us the flexibility to load many different kinds of materials that meet our customers' requirements while also maintaining regulatory compliance.
Now, I will always tell you that risk is directly proportional to yield strength. In an industry that really has a very tight validation and verification requirement to eliminate risk.
We want to make sure that we can mitigate all risk in the manufacturing process as possible.
We've spent a lot of time developing a process we call the MPM process, which stands for Materials Process and Machine.
It allows for the sequential control of the development cycles, from establishing parameters in our machines to optimizing for dimensions of the parts fabricated within those cycles.
Whether you're an airline or you're operating a UAV or a military asset, shift in polymers will be to those higher performance materials. And additive will start to enhance those in ways that we can't even imagine.